I hope all of you guys out there are doing well. I finally got this video finished. I've been working on this thing for a long time, over a year now actually. But the reason why it's taking me so long is because I wasn't able to work on it all at once. I had to do it in pieces. And the reason for that is, last year, last February, not this past, but the last February, I quit one of the bands I had been in for about 15 years, and because there was just a conflict of interest. Anyway, long story short, when word got out that I was available, I started getting all these calls to be like a type of a hired gun guitarist, come in and handle guitar duties for these different bands. And then before I knew it, I was playing in 5 different bands. So, and that lasted for about a year and a half. And the good thing about that is I had to practice a whole hell of a lot because it seemed like every few weeks I had to learn a different show. And so I was putting in a lot of practice every day, and it helped. It really helped me. All you young guitarists out there, when you're an up and coming guitarist, and even somebody who is established, practice is very important, okay? My chops have gotten way better since last year because of all the playing I've had to do and practicing I've had to do. So just a tip for you young guitarists out there, the more you practice, the better you're going to be, period. So, but at this point, I've finished most of my commitments that I've had, so I was able to finish this video. I've had a ton of requests for these things for over a year now. And so I put together some of my favorite guitarists and artist patches. Megadeth, Iron Maiden, finally got some John Petrucci patches, which there's not many out there, and the ones that are out there, I'm not sure how good they sound, but these sound really good. One thing I want to explain to you is, before I get into the patches, you know, a lot of these groups that I'm trying to emulate their sounds, these guitarists use real tube amps. Now, the thing you gotta learn about a real tube amp, it has tubes, of course, but then it has this thing that I like to call top-end tube sizzle, okay? Now for years, modelers have been trying to emulate that, and you've been hearing and reading on forums how, especially for the high gain tones, you're gonna read a lot where, oh, it sounds so fizzy, you know, it's too fizzy on the high end. Well, that's because these modelers are trying to model that sound of the tube sizzle, okay? And so we've developed EQs to take that away. But when you do that and you get it in the mix, it doesn't sound right, and you end up having to add more high end in the mix to compensate. So if you listen to these patches by themselves, you're gonna find that they have that high end tube sizzle, which I like to call it, okay? And if you compare them to the original sounds that I'm trying to emulate, you're going to hear that in those sounds too. So I didn't want to take that away. But just if for some reason it's too much for you, you can go into the global EQ settings of the GT100, and you can dial back that high end, and that'll take off some of the high end edge if you think it's too much for you. I've tried to put it where I thought it wasn't too much, but just right. And so I think I got it pretty close. Now, one more thing. People ask me, how did I come up with these sounds? Well, it's a long process. First, I research the artist. I research what gear they used. And then I try to find recordings of them. I listen to them. And I also try to find isolated guitar tracks of these artists, which most of them are on YouTube. Once I find that, I can really hone in on the sounds and the EQ settings and the crunch and the level of distortion and all that. So I do this by ear, and I'm able to just kind of hone in on certain things and emulate the sound as best as I can. And I think I've come pretty close on these. I'll let you be the judge on that. But I've had a lot of fun doing it, and I'm gonna get into the sounds now. Before I do, thank you guys so much for all of your support. I say this in every video, I really mean it. I really appreciate you guys' support, and I really enjoy talking with you from all over the world. I get comments, I get questions. I try to answer them right away, and it's a lot of fun. Got to know some of you guys through this, and that's a good thing. So if you have any questions about anything, you know, I'm always there on YouTube. I try to answer every question. I try to answer every single one that I can. I get a lot of them. It takes a lot of time, but I like doing that. So anyway, guys, that's enough talking. I'm going to get into the sounds now. Again, thank you so much. And here we go. Metal Masters for the Boss GT100.
Yeah, so I forgot to tell you a very important thing here. The signal path, guitar in, right here. Left and right, stereo out, right into my computer interface right there. That's it. No post-processing whatsoever. Straight out of the GT100, right into the audio interface. We'll be right back.
People's heads are rolling.